Gardeners oftentimes wish they had better soil. There's a lot of different ways that you can improve your soil, but sometimes you're faced with having to make a purchase. This video will introduce you on what to look for and how to make a wise decision on purchasing soil. Can you use the soil that you already have on site is the first thing to consider. So any soil that you're going to purchase is going to be mined from another site and may need to have adjustments to soil pH, nutrients, and organic matter. So it's worth considering putting that effort into amending the soil that you have on site and saving your time from actually going out and making that purchase and bringing it in. So there are a number of different ways that you can prep your own soil. Here we had a really weedy patch filled with a lot of perennial weeds in the lawn that we wanted to use as a garden. So about 4 months ago, we came in, we put some compost down on the site, and then covered it with a black tarp, anchored down with some sandbags. And now 4 months later, we have a fresh spot with very few weeds, and the compost is starting to incorporate in. This can work especially well in both sandy and compacted sites, but also clay sites as well. If you have a lot of coarse gravel, heavy clay soils, or a contaminated site, the next thing to consider is purchasing loam. Soil is made up of various sized particles of broken down pieces of rock. The larger particles are considered sand, medium-sized particles are silt, and the smallest sized particles are clay. Loam is a category of soil that has less than 28% clay and a mix of sand and silt that'll give it good drainage characteristics. With that said, there are no laws governing the sale of loam. In other words, what you're possibly purchasing may not truly be loam. So it's good to have some skills to understand how to assess what product you have in front of you. Before you go ahead and buy a product, go and see it and be prepared to get your hands dirty. You'll want to bring some water with you and just to be able to moisten it a little bit before you take a hold of it. Just grab a sample. Here it's already wet from a lot of rain, but form a ball. Try to form a ball with it and see if that ball sticks together. If it happens to be really sticky in your hands and you're getting a lot attached to your hands, that probably has a greater clay content. If it doesn't form a ball at all and it feels really gritty, if it's been moistened and everything, then that might be too gravelly or sandy to work with in a garden setting. So this gives you a really good idea generally as to how well it's going to drain in your soil. Some vendors may sell loam mixed with other products. In that case, you may want to ask them what the recipe of ingredients is and what those other ingredients are.
It is important to note that PFAS are a potential contaminant in soils amended with municipal sludge and loam mined from properties that have applied municipal sludge in the past. New information is emerging on this issue at a fast pace. We recommend asking your supplier about the history of the product they're selling and refer to our PFAS resource page for current information on how to assess risks to determine whether it's worth bringing into your landscape. Soil can also harbor invasive and aggressive species. Stay away from loam piles that contain plants with spreading rhizomes, invasive worms, and significant amounts of weeds.
Avoid any soils that have any odd odors or excessive amounts of debris. Some vendors may sell unscreened loam, which may be more affordable, but will leave you with a lot of extra labor to get rid of rocks and stones and branches and other debris. Lastly, you'll want to ask the vendor whether they have a soil test report from the batch that they'll be selling you, or if you can grab a sample for yourself to test through the Maine Soil Testing Service. A soil test report will give you valuable information about soil pH, nutrient levels, organic matter, and whether lead contamination is a concern. For an additional cost, you may want to request a soil texture analysis as well. That will help you identify whether it is a true loam or not. So what you'll do is you'll take 5 quarter-cup samples from throughout the pile, which we have here, and then follow the soil test instructions on the Maine Soil Testing Service website. Next, consider how much you need. UMaine has a great chart to walk you through that process. Most loam is low in organic matter. Organic matter helps improve the soil's moisture holding capacity, drainage, and structure, and also nutrient holding capacity. So you'll want to plan on adding about 10 to 20% organic matter by volume. You also might need to add other nutrients or amendments to adjust the pH, but wait until you get your soil test report back before you do those pieces.
Because of food safety issues, don't plant vegetable crops in soil recently amended with fresh animal manures. Age or compost the manure for at least 120 days before planting food crops.
Most bag soil products do not contain actual mineral soil, meaning sand, silt, and clay. Instead, they contain organic materials such as aged manures and peat moss or composts. And they don't have the enduring qualities that loam has for long-term projects. Those types of products, the bag products, are more appropriate for container garden projects that are more shorter term. So if you need to buy loam for your landscape projects, take the time to ask questions and see the product before you buy it. Any experienced gardener will tell you that good soil is the key to success.